Lectio Libri Danielis Prophetae. In a vision I, Daniel, saw during the night the four winds of heaven stirred up the great sea, from which emerged four immense beasts, each different from the others. The first was like a lion, but with eagle's wings. While I watched, the wings were plucked. It was raised from the ground to stand on 2 feet like a man and given a human mind. The second was like a bear. It was raised up on one side, and among the teeth in its mouth were 3 tusks. It was given the order, up, devour much flesh. After this, I looked and saw another beast like a leopard. On its back were 4 wings like those of a bird, and it had 4 heads. To this beast, dominion was given. After this, in the visions of the night, I saw the 4th beast, different from all the others, terrifying, horrible, and of extraordinary strength. It had great iron teeth with which it devoured and crushed, and what was left it trampled with its feet. I was considering the 10 horns it had, when suddenly another, a little horn, sprang out of their midst, and 3 of the previous horns were torn away to make room for it. This horn had eyes like a man, and a mouth that spoke arrogantly. As I watched, thrones were set up, and the Ancient One took his throne. His clothing was snow bright, and the hair on his head white as wool. His throne was flames of fire with wheels of burning fire. A surging stream of fire flowed out from where he sat. Thousands upon thousands were ministering to him, and myriads upon myriads attended him. The court was convened, and the books were opened. I watched then from the first of the arrogant words which the horn spoke, until the beast was slain and its body thrown into the fire to be burnt up. The other beasts, which also lost their dominion, were granted a prolongation of life for a time and a season. As the visions during the night continued, I saw one like a son of man coming on the clouds of heaven. When he reached the Ancient One and was presented before him, he received dominion, glory and kingship. Nations and peoples of every language serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingship shall not be destroyed. Verbum Domini. Deo gratias.
Ad te gloria, Maria, anima mea. Spiritus cum. Lectio Sancti Evangelii secundum Lucam. Jesus told his disciples a parable. Consider the fig tree and all the other trees. When their buds burst open, you see for yourselves and know that summer is now near. In the same way, when you see these things happening, know that the kingdom of God is near. Amen, I say to you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. Verbum Domini.
Please be seated. We have just a sliver of ordinary time left, just today and tomorrow. And then we will begin a new liturgical year, the Year of Grace 2024, this Sunday, the first Sunday of Advent. So as the liturgical year is quickly coming to a close, coming to an end, we could see that the church is directing our attention to those things which come to an end and those things which do not come to an end. We have this mysterious prophecy from the prophet Daniel as our first reading tonight. We hear about these four different beasts who come out of the sea. Now, the sea, very often in the Bible, is symbolic of the great abyss from which comes chaos and the demonic forces that plague us. You could think of when our Lord casts out the legion of demons and they go into the swine, and then the swine go back into the sea. Or probably the best illustration of this is when the apostles are in their boat on the Sea of Galilee, and this storm, this violent storm, comes and shakes them. Nothing can save them from this except the Lord himself. And so they wake him up, and with a word he calms the sea, showing he has dominion over even those demonic forces that are so powerful, that leave us so often feeling so helpless. So the sea is this place where these evil forces come from. And so in Daniel's vision, these four different beasts come forth from the sea. There's a lion, there's a bear, there's a leopard, and these three represent the three different kingdoms that had oppressed the nation of Israel, God's chosen people. But then there's this fourth beast that comes out of the great sea, and this is that kingdom that is still to come after Daniel's time. This is what he's prophesying about. But the prophecy doesn't end there. It's not just another kingdom that will oppress the people. The prophecy ends not with something coming out of the sea, but this time someone coming down from heaven. And this is one like a son of man coming on the clouds of heaven. When he reached the Ancient One, we heard, and was presented before him, he received dominion, glory, and kingship. Nations and peoples of every language serve him. We know what this prophecy is referring to. It's Christ. It's so clear to us that this is Christ. Christ even speaks this way about himself when he's standing on trial before the Sanhedrin. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingship shall not be destroyed. So here we find out those things which come to an end, all those kingdoms of this world, even the forces of the demonic that threaten us, all of that will come to an end. But what will not come to an end? The dominion of Christ. We say this in the Creed. When we say the Nicene Creed on Sundays, we say, his kingdom will have no end. Those words should bring us great comfort and consolation. Our Lord says in the Gospel today, heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. This is what we can take great comfort in. When it's so easy to get caught up with current events and everything that's going wrong in the world, well, we should know, we should constantly be reminded that all of that will pass away. As great and as mighty as those forces seem, it will come to nothing one day. Even our own worldly ambitions will come to nothing and will amount to nothing in the end. But there's one whose kingdom will not pass away, and that is Christ. He will not pass away. He has died and risen and lives forever, never to die again. His words will not pass away. His kingdom will not pass away.
Sis Domine et omnibus in Christo quiescentibus, locum refrigeri, lucis et pacis, ut indulgeas te precamur, per Christum Domino nostrum, amen. Nobis quoque peccatoribus familiis tuis, de multitudine interationum quorum sperantibus, artem aliquam et societatem donare dineris, cum tuis sanctis apostolis et martyribus, cum Ioannis, Stephano, Mattia, Barnaba, Ignatio, Alexandro, Marcellino, Petro, Felicitate, Perpetua, Agata, Lucia, Aniete, Cecilia, Anastasia, Domibus Sanctis Tuis, intra quorum, nos consortium, non estimator meriti, sed femine, quae suus, margitor admite, per Christum Dominum nostrum, per quem hic omnia Domine, semper cola creas, sanctificas, vivificas, benedicis et prestas nobis.
Er ipsum et cum ipso et in ipso, est tibi Deo Patri omnipotenti, in unitate Spiritus Sancti. Amen.